Hey guys, welcome back to part two with Scott and myself. We're going to answer a few more of your questions. So I'll start. Hi Scott, what would you do if Kate Ramsey came back to Ramsey Street and didn't actually die on screen?
I think Mark would fall in love again if she wasn't dead, but he kind of watched her die. So that would be weird. But stranger things have happened on Ramsey Street.
She might have a twin.
That could happen.
She might be out there somewhere.
She could be. No, I think that'd be great because I love Ashley Brewer and I would love her back. But I love
you
too.
Is this your love interest before?
Yes. We were a very popular couple, I'll have you know.
Oh, really? But she covers it all.
Should we fill in Jodi on what happened? So what happened was I proposed. We were in love for a long time and I proposed. Mm. And as I proposed and we were about to hug, she got shot and she died in my arms.
Oh, gosh. How long ago was that?
I want to say 3 years ago.
Oh, so you should be over it or you're not?
Well, I mean, she's always going to be in my heart, you know. I always think about her each and every day.
Maybe that's why he's in the police force. He kind of does it for her.
Yeah, I was in the police force before that. Anyway, Jodi, what's your character Ellie's good and bad personality traits?
I'm just going to rattle them all off and you can put them in whatever category you want. So she's fun, she's feisty, she's smart, but she's lazy. She's also, she's intelligent but lazy, which is a really interesting thing for me to play. She's very lazy when it comes to work. She has kind of really weird, strange, unconventional ways of teaching. She can be a little bit promiscuous, but then she also has the ability to connect with people and show that really deep and meaningful side of her. And I think deep down, Ellie is a really good person and she has good intentions. She just needs to find herself. And I feel like she's in the right place to do that.
Yeah.
So she's a mixed bag.
She is.
Mixed bag of lollies.
She is.
What do you think?
And she's very endearing. None of it comes from a bad place.
She's manipulative sometimes and then she catches herself doing that and then she will kind of make up. She'll always do something good for something bad that she does. So, you know, she skates that kind of fine line. But I do believe that the essence of Ellie is a good person. She seems to find herself. Yep. Okay, Scott, your turn. Alicia Woolner. Scott, do you think that Mark should have been promoted by now? I think that being a detective really suited his character.
So do I. I think you make a very valid point. It was always a little odd to me that he went from being a detective to a constable. And he's done a lot of great jobs lately. He's, he's worked hard and he's found who was responsible for blowing up Lassiter's. And you would think he deserves some sort of a...
I'm wondering, did this happen after Kate died? Did he need to step back a little bit?
Mark left the police force.
Right.
Guys, again, we're just going to fill in Jodi here.
I'm thinking that's why he, demoted himself.
Well, he left the police force and part of coming back to the police force was like, well, you're going to start from scratch. So that's kind of what happened.
But so that's kind of right.
I think he should be promoted for sure. He should be at least a first constable. And the other problem I have is it's really hard to, demand things of other police officers when you're a constable, which probably doesn't happen. They're kind of like an apprentice on the work site.
Right.
You know, they get told what to do. So I think he should be at least a senior constable by now.
Senior Constable Brennan?
Yeah. There you go.
There we go.
Bonbon's Voyage.
Wait a minute. No, that's my question.
It's because I look at the pink bit and then I go, okay, I've done that.
For some reason,
I'm an idiot.
You're the pink bit and I'm the not pink bit.
Yeah.
Do you not highlight your lines? I don't highlight my lines.
I do.
Well, I don't. Yeah. That's why I'm looking at the parts that aren't highlighted. Uh-huh. Anyway.
All right, I'm going to start again.
There you go. Hey, I highlight my lines.
Here's a fun fact.
Fun fact.
I highlight my lines.
I don't. I put a little dash next to them.
Do you?
Mm. Yeah.
What happens when you need to refer to them really quickly?
Well, I kind of know on a page how many sections I have.
Yeah.
It's not... I don't know.
Probably should know our lines anyway, shouldn't we?
Yeah, I know what you mean, and a lot of people do highlight, and I did highlight for a long time, but now I just... I mean,
here's another fun fact.
Oh,
this is very
today.
This is very Mark Brennan of me. I use two colours, sometimes even three, to highlight my lines. And why I do that...
Next level.
...is
next
because
level.
What I do is, again, I get a lot of dialogue.
So do I.
A lot of...
I think we should
of,
have a dialogue off because my character doesn't stop talking.
And I have a lot of technical stuff as well. I'm not saying mine is harder.
However, flirt. Do you know how hard that is to convey in a... You know,
but what I like to do is I highlight everything in yellow and then I use green to highlight the most important parts. And then sometimes if I'm struggling a little bit more, if there's any technical stuff that I really need to hit, I highlight it in orange on top of that. So sometimes my scripts are yellow, green, orange, they've got pen all over it.
I'm just thinking about the multicoloured rainbow.
Very Mark Brennan. Yep.
Mark Brennan or Scott McGregor?
Well, that's very Mark Brennan of Scott McGregor.
There you go, guys. Fun fact for the day.
Yep. Leonie asks, it's my mum's name.
Is it?
Hi, Leonie.
Hi, Leonie.
I love your name.
Amazing name.
Ask each other a question of your choice.
Okay, Mark, what has been your favourite storyline so far? Besides meeting Elly.
Which was a fun scene when we met.
Yeah, it's my first scene that's airing Monday the 18th.
It's fun. Yeah. I hope it comes up good. I haven't seen it, but I remember
filming
it. I feel
like
it really good,
summarizes Elly, that first scene, which is nice.
Yeah.
Maybe a bit cheekier than
And a little bit of a different side to Mark, which you don't usually see.
Yeah. Which I didn't realise. I was just at the time, I thought that that's just your character.
No, it was totally not my character.
It was good.
It was fun. What was your
question? What's been your favourite storyline so far?
Again, you weren't here, but there was we did a storyline where my character had to go into witness protection. I say this every time.
Right.
And I had to leave Erinsborough really quickly. And I asked Kate to come with me. She says yes, but there's a meeting point. She doesn't make it in time, but we all did it at real time. So that when you're watching it, it's the actual time that it all happens. It was really... viewers will know all about it. Yeah.
Oh my gosh, so uneducated.
Yeah, but that was probably my favourite storyline. Well, cool. What else has there been? I don't remember.
That sounds like a fun one.
Yeah, it's a fun... Actually, stay tuned because I got told yesterday...
Yeah.
Which I haven't even read it yet, but I got told the premise of a storyline that's coming up, which is going to be huge. Huge. And it involves four of the main cast, which probably involve some more people, but mainly...
Trying to think if I'm involved or not. Even I don't know.
Nah. Yeah. Well, look, I'm not going to say whether you are or you aren't, but I found out only yesterday, so maybe you're yet to find out.
Oh, my gosh.
But
this
is a fantastic... storyline, which, what's the word I'm looking for? It's going to divide people. It's just, I can't wait to sink my teeth into it. I can't wait to film it and I can't wait to see how it comes out. So I'm excited.
Well, thanks for sharing with us nothing.
Well, I can't give much away. I can't give much away, but there's going to be a lot of emotions involved and,
gosh, even I'm looking forward to watching it.
Yeah, yeah. No, it's going to be great. Mm. Trust me.
Okay. Tune in, guys.
I need to ask you a question.
Oh, I thought we were skipping that. What's going to be?
My question to you is...
Yes.
You worked on another show, which I'm not going to name names, that we all may know of, which is a very similar show to what we film here at good old Ramsey Street.
Hmm.
What are your favourite things about Neighbours that may not have been so much the case of this other show that we won't mention?
You're funny. It's very sneaky of you to ask me that, Scott.
Why not?
But the thing is...
Is it the people?
Honestly, they're quite fundamentally similar.
Yep.
They really are.
Yep.
And one thing I notice that stood out to me a lot since I've started on Neighbours is that when I'm on set, I'm completely relaxed and everyone has a great synergy on set with the cast, the crew, the production, and it's very, very relaxed. And that's something I've never had on any of the other jobs that I've had before. And I don't know if it's just me and where I'm at or if it's, I'm pretty sure it's the set and the people. Yeah. And there's a really great chemistry and vibe between everyone here. And it's nice. Pretty nice to go to work every day
we
with
should
that.
Give a shout out to the crew, shouldn't we?
We love you, crew.
Yeah, we love you guys.
Andy, this is for you.
Hey, he does the hicking.
What?
Andy does the hicking.
Okay.
People are going to be watching this what are they doing?
Okay, one more question for you, Scott. Bon Bon's Voyage, if you won the lottery tomorrow, what would be the first three things that you buy?
Well, it would depend on how much I won.
Let's say 20 mil.
20 mil?
Just, ballpark figure.
You're not going to like this answer, but I'd probably buy myself a golf course. Yeah,
that would only cost like 3 mil, 4 mil.
It's about $1 million a hole. There's 18 holes, about 80 mil.
He wants to buy Augusta, people.
Yeah. Oh, you can't do that. I would build myself a golf course. Second thing, I would buy myself like a first class ticket around the world, maybe, so just 6-star accommodation in the most amazing places I could find.
Okay, now say something humble, please.
What do you mean?
Buy your mum you buy Leonie a gold house.
I bought my mum a cruise, a nice cruise to Vanuatu and back. Thank you very much. So I do things.
And now, mum, nice you're things. Upgrading to a gold house. And he said he'd get one for me too, so great.
There you go. That's what I'd buy.
That's four. Perfect answer.
Do we have any more questions?
No, that's it.
Oh, that's it.
That's it, guys.
Well, thanks so much for sending in your questions. I hope you enjoyed our answers. Yes. I hope they weren't too long-winded. And I hope that you've learnt a lot about Mark Brennan and previous storylines.
Thank you for teaching me so much about Mark Brennan. Nice to chat with you guys.
Bye.